Hey, John McElhenney here. And I just got through listening to Rick Beato's scary video about how AI, not gonna kill us all, but going to flood the music channels, Spotify and everything else, with all this AI non-human music, and they don't have to pay royalties to the AI fake artists, right? So it was scary. Rick, cut that out. There are some very specific things we could ask for, but I think the fulcrum is going to be Taylor Swift. I know, old saw, she's done it before. The last time Free Taylor trended, she had pulled all of her music off Spotify and Apple Music to protest not being able to play one of her songs that she didn't own the rights to on the Grammys performance. So the Swifties rallied and everyone rallied, and that led to Taylor's version, where she and her father funded re-recordings of all of her early albums. Well, now that's amazing, but there's probably no other artist alive that could afford to re-record their previous albums to exclude their publisher and record label originally on those earlier tracks. So Taylor's already done this for herself. And here's my pitch. Taylor needs to take all of her music off Spotify and Apple Music. She made $110 million in royalties from Spotify in December alone. So Taylor doesn't need the money. Her dad doesn't need the money. But Taylor could create a lasting legacy by forcing the Spotify's and the Apple Music and the YouTube Musics of the world to pay royalties to artists who record, and maybe they don't play live. Maybe they don't have a lot of merch. Maybe they're dead. Don't you think all music should be paid for? Well, today, when music is free, or at best, $10 to $15 a month unlimited on your streaming service, there are very few artists who are making any money in recorded music. Of course, Taylor has the top 14 songs on Spotify. So she's bringing it in. Why would she tell Spotify to do something different? And here's my pitch. Taylor has the money to change the industry for all musicians for all time. And here's how it works. She pulls all of her music. She uses maybe that $110 million she made in December to build an alternative streaming service. I've put some ideas up, redradio.io or Radio Red. I even bought the domain taylorsversion.ai, thinking we just need to get the idea in front of her, but in a way that makes sense. Of course, immediately it makes no financial sense. She's about to go out on another world-busting tour on the back of an album that, to me, sounds like half of the patterns and progressions were written by AI. They're so generic and vanilla. I've written on that before. But she has no motivation to pull the plug again and do a Free Taylor campaign or use some of her winnings that we've all paid for, right? We all bought Taylor Swift tickets. We're going to do it again and again and again. What if Taylor Swift could change the music industry for all musicians, for all recording musicians? And what if all those fans that are watching Taylor Swift concerts who want to be like Taylor, they want to be musicians too? Don't you think Taylor's legacy would be bigger and more powerful if she was the one that made recorded music payable again? I mean, doesn't she want her fans to be able to be musicians as well? Anyway, Rick, I really think your platform, of course, with millions of subscribers, and your passion for the music, passion for musicianship, passion for human-generated rhythms, human-generated patterns, human timings that don't stay in a clock like the 808 beats that every top single now has the exact same sounds, including dang near every track on the new Taylor Swift record. So Rick, when you see this, and I'm guessing you will, let's pair up. Let's talk about this. Let's see how, with some leverage from real musicians, I'm just an amateur, we could maybe talk some sense, or talk some altruism, or give Taylor a little bit about the real world and those musicians that she loves to parade out on stage with her as if they're playing along, when really they're just actors. Yes, many of those people on stage with Taylor are the musicians, but they're not playing. The entire performance is taped. It's much more like a halftime show than a live show, and you can see it. You can hear it if you know what you're listening for. Anyway, AI is coming for all of our jobs. It's coming for musicians. It's coming for artists, writers. Anything creative, AI is going to be able to mimic. But I'm fighting for creativity and human-generated art. Rick, won't you join me? And let's see if we can free Taylor from the prison that she's in. Thanks. Hope you're having a good one. Click subscribe if you like it. And don't click subscribe if you don't. Thanks for listening.